श्रीमती रमण शर्मा वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सीरियस एंड सिग्निफिकेंट इश्यू इज बीइंग पॉइंटेड हियर द टॉपिक बीइंग एनर्जी विदाउट एनर्जी द एग्जिस्टेंस द सस्टेनेंस and perpetuating action of anything cannot be completed. That vital source, which is known as energy, is there in the form of nutrients, which are in the form of food once again to supply to human beings, to sustain themselves and to act effectively. Likewise, whatever the tools that have been handled by human beings, they had an inherent stature of compatibility as well as sturdy, which is said to be the energy to withhold the process of actions of human beings. And number two, in the advent of development of science or the technical evolution, the first stage of action of human beings in which the physical execution has been made has been promoted to handling of tools, which is known as association or activation. Then to enhance the level of action, which thus the work of a human being in a hyper rapid manner within a short time frame, increasing more productivity, that is the era of automation. So first action, second is activation, handling of tools, third is automation. So with a rapid system of operation, with more precision, with multiplicity of productivity, within a very very limited or infinitesimal time frame is the era of automation. Now we are in the fourth era, the era of artificial intelligence, whereby everything is designed, pre-programmed, sensed by various apt mechanisms. So naturally, now we are in a dual race. The more we invent, more than the inventions or innovations we used to exhaust or exploit or explore, we used to utilize. So there is a dual race going between the new innovative measures as well as the rising demand of this society, as well as the utilities, obviously, of this society, resulting in lot of oscillations, fluctuations, and insufficiencies in growing demands. Then this has resulted in more cogitation or scientific contemplation into the roles of first to explore, identify, and produce more energy. And second is to distribute energy, to implant the distribution systems. Third is to use more energy with high energy demand. Then how to minimize the energy and to increase the expensive work of our acts. And later on it became alternative sources of energy, mixed sources of energy, that is hybrid forms of energy. Then perpetuity or perennial source of energy, then now we are dreaming about inexhaustible source of energy. So likewise the dream or the exploration system is going on like that. Then gradually the human beings in this era, they have to get into some system. That's why we used to say in ethics that God has given scattered resources and sharing instincts. These resources, which are in the form of either power or resource fuels for getting power or technology for generating power, these things are known as the three things, three major things which are to be shared. Either the source of power or power itself or technology to generate power, it must be shared. This sharing requires lot of things like abundance of energy sources. And second, proper relations, proper salubrity or salubrious relations between the interpolitical scenario. And moreover, apart from this thing, it must be also economically viable. And fourth main thing is, whenever you get the energy, instead of consuming it voraciously, you must try to apply it for producing more energy. So these four major things in the system of getting energy, that is sharing energy resources in the form of energy, energy base and technology, that is now being pondered by people. This has resulted in the formation of various dimensional thought and scrutiny, just as efficiency drive to increase more efficiency. Second is risk reduction, how to reduce the risk. And already the impacts that have been contributed by us to the environment by means of our mismanagement or misbehavioral exploitation of the nature, that impact must be analyzed and tried to be mitigated and extirpated. Fourth thing is how to make it cost efficient or minimize the cost system of it, and then how to design it so that it can have a minimal waste and waste management facilities. Final thing is decent usage. Decent usage of energy is proper usage of energy, then perfect usage of energy without any wastage. Third thing is productive usage of energy, not for any destructive purposes. This is known as decent usage of energy. This is a move. And these things have created new dimensional approach to the energy sciences, such as energy psychology, energy philosophy, energy statistics, energy logics, energy dynamics, innumerable dimensions. They have been made to discuss about major issues of shortage of energy. First thing is insufficiency. Even if there are abundant sources, whenever you are going on exhausting the energy, it will be insufficient. Number two, inefficient. The energy that is available cannot meet the growing demand of the society. That is inefficient. Third thing, expensive. Most of the projects, most of the systems are there very expensive, so that we cannot economically make it viable so that energy can be produced and distributed. Fourth thing is arduous. It is technically very risky and it demands a technological revolution or evolution so that we can meet the things to be done. Fifth thing is hazardous. We can do, but there are a lot of hazards. Sixth thing is ambiguous. Whether that is hazardous or not, still it has not been finalized. Seventh or the final thing is obscure. It is an obscurity. Most of the things we have the plan, like helionics, gravitational tapping, nanoenergy, algae energy generation, algae energetics. Innumerable such systems are there, which are just there in phenomena, just there in some sort of comprising within the tenets and the frame of our opinions and suggestions, which is not fructified into scientific or technical usage. So these things are the major things which we are going to discuss, resulting in the fancy models which we want more. We want three fancy models. One, we have to continuously use and energy must not be depleted. Number two, we must give low input, but we must have high work at the end. Third thing, we must have full power, but we must not have any danger at all. These three fancy models are being contemplated by various measures, various analytical people throughout the world. Now coming into account, now everything is fully instrumental, collective instrumental, everything is based on artificial intelligence, I already told. So we need lot of systems to work out. So we need high efficiency machines which have low power input or which has low power basic operation systems. Now we have an ultra low power computer system, recently it has been designed, in which instead of the electron flow, which is there conventionally as per the Moore's law, which drives the gate for information, which are then embedded into transmitters, which are then compressed into a microchip. Instead of the spin property of a particular electron, without moving the electrons, they are concerned in which less energy waste is there. It is known as Dr. Wang's logic gate. The only problem with that is, now that logic gate is not capable of breaking the signals or dismantling the signals to multiple gates so that it can be made as a proper way of what we call a transistor, which can be then embedded into a microchip to form a logical processing system inside a computer. So that is the problem, that it cannot be properly systematized to form a microchip or a transistor, number one. And number two, transportation consumes more energy, and that is the main reason for most of the greenhouse effects of the global system. And now recently electricity driven cars are there, like Aptera company, it has launched a car in which the panel is on the basis of solar cells. That is, solar panel roof cells are made in that Aptera cars, which are going to come, which has a capability to be driven for 190 kilometers, having the natural energy, zero wastage energy into possibility. Likewise, there is one roaster system. There is one roaster company which is releasing this sports car, in which recently they have made such a system to have embedded solar panels, by which by the cost efficiency of 2 cents per kilometer they can drive, which is very, very cheap and economical than any other fuel. So such things are there in the move. And third, we are mainly coming into the fuel cells. Fuel cells, they are very clean, perfect and efficient. Naturally, fuel cells are like that. And these fuel cells, they are of different types, you know that. There is a positron, that is a proton exchange membrane cell is there. A cell with alkaline is there, phosphoric acid is there, molten carbonate is there, solid oxide is there, direct methanol fuel cell is there. Innumerable such cells are used in the fuel cell technology. Fuel cell technology is very easy, that between two electrodes, there is an electrolyte. And this electrolyte creates the electrochemical equivalent of combustion. And without burning, it releases energy by pushing the electrons. As it does not burn, it does not give any pollution at all. So it is totally pollution free. And hydrogen fuels, generally, they give only water, whereas the fossil fuels, they give H2O plus CO2, carbon dioxide, which is a greenhouse gas. So that is in fuel cell. Fuel cells we can just, now they are using in NASA, the space shuttles, they are operated by fuel cells. And in Vancouver and Chicago, they have operated, they have tested and operated with the systems which are called as in the transportation devices. And there is a company, US International Fuel Cell Devices Company is there. Now they are also planning to make electronic gadgets as well as power stations in H2. The only problem is the membrane as well as the catalyst used are very expensive. To bring down the price, they are doing some measures. That is in fuel cell. Now recently, Dr. Grail Robuster, he has designed that there is a fungus in the Ulmo tree, that is a cordifolia species in Ulmo tree, there is a fungus which can create diesel vapor, which can convert plant waste into diesel vapor, and a large amount of effective hydrocarbons such as octane, they have been found. And it is also having a special design of genes which can create enzymes which can break cellulose into diesel vapor. But still, how much productivity can be made, that is yet this process is going on for test to apply the same thing in a moving car, practically viable. This is on fungus. So there is also a possibility of biomass or biofuel through a fungus that has also been made. Then there is also a critical way of analysis made by people known as geoengineering, in which they consider that directly we can contact with the nature instead of mitigation of the global warming and other things, etc. Direct we can chemically contact with the ether as well as the oceanic and earth surfaces. They made two attempts which were very hazardous, more hazardous than the global warming itself. It is just throwing tiny sulfur particles into the ether so as to bounce back the sun's heat energy to the ether itself. And second thing is tiny iron particles are boosted into the oceanic tide, and they think that it will mitigate the global warming system. And now it has been already tested in a limited way, and the results have shown that this iron induces the growth of an algae which produces a lot of neurotoxins known as domoid acid. This domoid acid that will totally put an end, that will annihilate the amphibian, the and otherwise the pisces community of the abysmal living. So totally that will enhance the way of destruction more, and it is more hazardous. It is known as geoengineering. What I want to say here is, whatever we are doing in the form of just chemical retaliations for the same chemical compounds which were hazardous, that is not going to be a real solution. We have to think about the long-term effect and benefit. So it is not possible there. So apart from this geoengineering, next to the main thing we are going to attempt is, even in small thing, like there is a sticker. The sticker tape, if it is peeled off and sticked again and peeled off, it releases that X-rays. And if the same thing, instead of electrons, if they are applied towards molecules, they can just adjust and just can accumulate nuclear fusion. But deuterium and tritium ions, the basic ions, if they are handled in 515 keV in a high energy field, then a fusion may be possible. That energy is so infinitesimal in just a striping off or peeling off a particular sticky tape, that is very feeble, that is very infinitesimal, to produce high levels of energy. Then we are having the nuclear energy, which is the previous speaker, he has very much elaborated. But nuclear energy has no discretion. Civilian and military uses are within the people, and it has no discretion. Even radioactive wastage is there, storage has been asked. We can store and we can control the impact of radioactive wastage and hazard. How to deal with the hyperactive non-state reactors who are going to handle that? How you are going to avoid the human hazards of the reactive or radioactive wastage? Radioactive wastage, inherently they can be just stored by a process and they can be handled with safety. But how to do with human these things, unless transformation in civilization and the ethical values of users and consumers, unless it comes, there is no usage at all. The second thing is, yes, the second thing is, after this we are having hydro energy. 1/5 of the hydroelectricity produced is going to be a supplement for the whole energy system of the world. And moreover, China is having the Three Gorges project, in which it is having 26 turbines, which gives the 18 coal-firing thermal stations power in the turbine itself, producing 3% of the energy demand of China. And even it is known that the Empress of that England, she is getting energy from the Thames by a hydroelectric project. That is also going on. Wind energy is very much to be pondered now, because that is very safe also and availability is also there. Wind energy is certain to be pondered. Now Scotland has the most wonderful and potential wind energy force. US is trying to implant 1/5 of the energy production from the wind energy. Integrated turbines are being made, and 19,640 turbines are being constructed in Germany at all. Now China is planning for a 50 gigawatts of energy by 2015. Now Dr. Peter Hope has designed an advanced system of that rotation fan blades in which we can produce, we can harness more energy. Clipper Company of California, they have made 75 feet or 75 meter large size of blades by which you can get more energy. And the statistical report says clearly that the annual average global wind speed is 106 million gigawatts hour per year, which is more than the 5 times the generation of what we are doing the electricity for now. So we are having 5 times more than what we generate by multiple sources. So wind sources are there, photovoltaic sources are there, photovoltaic source now they are going to discuss, and they are very much available. Cheap sources are there. Now flexible coverings in buildings and in shutware, it is going to come to harness more energy. Likewise, we are having geothermal energy, which we are having in Iceland. We are having ocean thermal energy, which is made by Mackay Ocean Engineering Institute. They made, but 2003 they made in India at Bay of Bengal, and they failed. So innumerable sources like these sources are going to come in. Intuitively, we want to say something, because we must understand sociology, economy, political history, various other responses. Merely studying energy, it will not come into any conclusion. So the concluding session, I am going to give you 3 major points. Number one, the global outlook. The global outlook of the energy system now is, what is the gas reserve and what is the access to oil reserves that exist now? What is the usage that we are going to do, as well as the emission level that we have to match? And then how to create alternative policies for energy productivity, as well as domestic usages, as well as for transports. Domestic usages, there are 2 villages in Italy as well as in Austria. They have their own power by photovoltaic cells, and also by means of their own power generation, hydroelectric power, they are self-supplying with energy. So we must induce, government must induce plans like produce your own energy, and any village, institution and individual or NGO promoting energy, they must be awarded like Nobel. So unless energy independence is given to people to produce their own energy, their enthusiasm is kindled by means of mini powerhouses they have to make, and mini sensors. If a person is not there inside the auditorium, automatically all of the power systems should shut up. Shutdown act, automatically it must happen. That is power sensor, mini power transformer, mini generator we have to utilize for conserving more energy, preserving and reserving more energy. That is known as real energy management. Now I am going to tell the very important point, which is known as meta-energetics. That is the energy of energy. Apart from the energy, we are having 3 more energy, our physical energy, mental energy and intellectual energy. If the intellectual energy does not consider about the mind energy, that is the mind which is using for destructive purposes, the mind that is selfish, the mind that is very maliciously robustic, all of these mental situation, the global and social existing and emerging mental setup must be considered by intellectuals, as well as now in the context of energy, transportation and other facilities, domestic facilities, nobody works at all. So inability for digestion, inability for accumulation of food and energy forces, everybody is suffering from a lot of diseases. So meta-energetics deals with application of intellectuals towards energy, in which they consider about the basic energy. So the associative energy for this energy is body. The energy that is using this energy is the mind. The energy that has dedicated this energy or detected the energy is intellect. They also should be considered. That is known as energy decency. I hope and wish that that should come in India. So generally there are 3 things what you say techno status. One is pride, second is partnership, third is produce share. If somebody produces, we can share it, that is different. Somebody does it, we can join with them, that is partnership. But I want, apart from partnership and produce share, that India should have the pride of designing such an energy that it is really inexhaustible from the sources of gravitational tapping, number one. The second, I told wind energy that is inexhaustibly available, nobody can exhaust it. Third, by means of the photovoltaic systems. And fourth, by means of the nano energy systems. So India should get the pride, it should enhance the study between the students, it should also encourage research scholars, and also it should teach the administrative people as well as the civilians how to use energy, how to augment and store energy and distribute it safely and prosperously. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
Thank you, sir. I'm Ash Kumar from NGO working at Renewable Energy Development Activities. And thank you for the history of giving a nice exposition on energy system in India. The India is a leading agricultural domain country. 80%, 60 to 70% live in rural area, and 80% proper not access to energy system. What should be the energy scenario required for a development of common equity, environment, energy, and economic development and social development. What should be a strategic plan for India?
It is more descriptive than my answer. There are two things. Number one, a customized system of operation. Second thing, well-equipping a nation as per the global scenario. So if we want to participate in the leading nations of power, certainly we have to enrich our status as per the global scenario by more nuclear power, by nanotechnology, by various other emerging and various other contemplated technologies. But still, we have to customize things as per our status. One is the heritage of our land, second is the natural resources that are available in our land, third thing is the natural economy of our land, fourth is the mental setup of our land. Without understanding the mindset of that is the collective consciousness of any land, you cannot impart, you cannot just generalize any system here. No doubt, agriculture is the basic, vibrant medulla oblongata of our nation. Whole world that is there. That's what I'm going to say. In biofuels, if you are going to produce only elephant grass and saplings and soy oil is to be diverted for all of these things, then what you will consume? You cannot consume diesel or something else. So we have to increase the productivity. First of all, man. Second, that is machine. Man, mind and machine. Man must be energized, mind must be made pure and sharp, and machines must be energized. If these three things, ethics, efficiency and environment, if these three things are not equally, equipotentially, not evenly, equally and equipotentially, if they are not charged, that is going to be a hazard to a nation.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for that.